So let us now go ahead and use these laws of logarithms and try to see some simple problems, how the problems can be simplified using logs or how the problems can be made complicated using logs. So let us see the first problem. It looks an ugly sum or ugly product, and we have taken log, and how the process is simplified when you use the properties of logarithm that you have studied just now, or the laws of logarithm that you have studied just now. So let us go ahead and do that. So this particular thing, let me write this to be equal to. So first you identify or isolate the terms that you identify can be separated. So first the term that I can separate out is this x cube. The second term that I can separate out is this square root, and the third term is numerator. So essentially this particular term, if you look at it, split can be split into three components. So I want end result that I want to get after simplification should have three components. Okay, so first I will apply the quotient rule, that is log of m by n. So in this case, this fetches me log to the base a of the numerator, which is x cube times x square plus 1 raised to half minus log to the base a of x plus 3 raised to 4. So here I have not used any other rule. So this is simply the quotient rule that I have used. That is the second rule that we have derived. Let us go ahead and see what we can do with the first term, that is this term. So now you can see, is simply see, these terms can be characterized into two terms. This is the first term and this is the second term. So I can write this particular thing as log to the base a of x cube plus log to the base a of x square plus 1 the whole raised to half. So to identify the raised to half is inside the log, I have put it this way. Okay, then minus, you look at this term again. Now in this term something is raised to the power 4. Do I have any rule for indices of the indices within the argument of logarithm? Yes, we have just now proved it for set of natural numbers. So you can use this, that rule, and say that this is equal to minus 4 times log to the base a of x plus 3. Let us go ahead and do a similar thing for the other two terms that are listed here. Then we will get the final answer, that is 3 times log to the base a of x plus half times, here I am using it for rational numbers which I have not proved, x square plus 1 minus 4 times log to the base a of x plus 3. Yeah, so this is how I can simplify. Now in general, when you study logarithms, people generally get confused between the product becoming the sum. So here we have some terms like this. Now these terms cannot be handled with log. So right now let me give you a note of caution or a warning, so to speak. That is, let me write this as warning. Generally, it is obvious, but while doing the calculation, people use this rule, log to the base a of m plus n is log to the base a of m plus log to the base a of n. So this is what people use, and they try to solve the problem so that they think they will simplify. But remember, this is not equal to that. Why? Because we have just now proved that this is nothing but log to the base a of mn. So these two things are different. In a similar manner, you can have a quotient rule, that is log to the base a of m minus n is not equal to log to the base a of m minus log to the base a of n. because this is actually equal to log to the base a of m by n. So just remember this warning, because generally in the when you are in the fighting spirit, you are trying to solve the problem, you tend to make these mistakes and which will ruin your entire answer. So this is with extra star mark, I am emphasizing that these two are not equal. Okay, now let us try to see how we can simplify. So we have here seen how we can simplify our life using logarithms, where everything is now almost a linear term except for this quadratic term. Now the next question that can be asked is, can you combine using logs? The answer is yes. So if you don't want to see such a big expression, or you want to have a nice compact expression, the question is, can you combine? The answer is yes. And now let us handle the terms one by one and merge the terms. So first term, let us take these first two terms. What are these two terms? One is 2 times log to the base a of x. So you have already seen log to the base a of x raised to r is r times log to the base a of x. Apply that in reverse. So you will get this particular term as log to the base a of x square. Don't stop there. You just apply the product rule now. Log to the base a of 2 times log to the base a of x plus log to the base a of 9 can actually be merged, as we can use this rule and say this is equal to 9 times x square. Okay, now let us look at the next term, which is this, next two terms in fact, and there is a negative sign. So naturally a quotient rule will come, and you will have something like log to the base a of x square plus 1 upon 5. Can you combine these two? Again apply the product rule and you will get this to be equal to log to the base a of 9 x square times x square plus 1 upon 5. So this is how you can simplify your life while studying logarithms by giving a combined expression. So you can use this to simplify your life, give a long expression with positive signs. When it will help? When you have lot of large numbers to be calculated. You can also combine the logarithmic terms and combine the expression in a compact form. When this will help? When you have lot of small terms that are unnecessarily occupying the space. So when extremely large terms come, the simplification will help. When extremely small terms will come, the matter will be simplified by combining the terms. So these are two simple avenues where you can actually do something. Okay, so I have already warned you about this log to the base a of m plus n. This is nothing. You can't get anything out of this. This is nothing. In a similar manner, log to the base a of m plus n, you cannot use reverse exponential or any other form to get something out of this while solving the problems of logarithms. So just whenever these such terms come, be aware and don't apply the things blindly.